Hello, today I'm here to explain how to find the centroid of overlapping buffer regions and create new buffer geometry in QGIS. On this map of the United States, I have points of garlic mustard observations that I'm interested in. I want to characterize a buffer region around each of these points, which would ultimately allow me to ask research questions about surrounding land cover characteristics and other species. To create a buffer, I'm going to go to Vector, Geoprocessing Tools, then Buffer. When you look at the distance field where you define the buffer radius, you'll notice that it is currently in the unit degrees. I want to change this to define my buffers in terms of meters, so I'm going to close out of this. So to change it to meters, you're going to need to change the CRS, or coordinate reference system. I'm going to export my map of the US and rename it to something I'll remember, and save the CRS that covers my region and uses meters. So I'm going to save this to state boundaries transformed and put it in a location that I'll remember. And I'm going to change this to EPSG 5070, which is Conus Albers, which covers my area and is also in meters, and I'll resave this. Okay, now I am going to do the same exact thing for my garlic mustard observations once I get rid of my old map file. So again, I'm going to re-export my garlic mustard observations. I'm going to rename it to something I'll remember in a location that has enough storage. And I am going to make sure that I save this in EPSG 5070 and resave. So now I have transformed map and transformed points, so I can get rid of my old map and old points. I'm just going to quickly change the color of my map, so that way there's a little bit more contrast than pink and purple. So I'm just going to change it to this beigey color to help see the points a little bit better. So the final step to changing the CRS is to also change the project CRS, which is in the bottom right-hand corner, so also make sure that is 5070. So you notice now that the map is a little bit more condensed when before it was a little bit stretched. So now we can re-change our buffers, and again, I'm going to now make it a 50-meter buffer, and you're going to notice the units changed to meters, and you can save this. So now if you zoom in, you're going to realize that you have a bunch of buffered points with a centroid. Eventually, if your observations are consolidated like mine, you're probably going to have buffer overlap. As you can see with me randomly zooming in on a random part of my map, I found a cluster of overlapping buffers. And I want to eliminate overlapping buffers to avoid double counting observations and overestimating whatever I choose to measure within my buffer regions. So the first step towards finding a centroid of the clusters is to create a new buffer to dissolve the result, to make sure that you're dissolving the buffers rather than the centroids. So I'm going to go to dissolve, dissolve my buffers, let that load. So this is going to join the geometry of the points. And in the attribute table, we only have one observation. So what's happening here is that QGIS took everything and made it into one big part. But I want everything to be discrete. So I'm going to go to multi-parts to single parts and just make sure that my buffers are selected. And now if you look into the attribute table of the single parts, you'll see that there's a bunch of different observations. So now you'll notice that we have discrete parts, but the buffer geometry is different between them. I'm going to change this by first finding the centroids of every distinct polygon. So you go to Vector, Geometry Tools, Centroid, and ensure that you check the box that says Create Centroid for each part. So now we have a new centroid for each of our polygons. So again, I'm going to create 50-meter buffers around this centroid. So I'm going to go back to my buffer, create a new 50-meter radius around that, and you can see that now we have a center new buffer geometry that covers up all of my old buffer geometry. So now we have a buffer of uniform size that was created, and buffers that now had no overlaps were simply re-replicated. So this is how I go from a bunch of overlapping buffers to one central new buffer that you can now get rid of any scratch layers that you don't need, and save your centroids and buffer regions that are brand new. Thank you for listening.